Headed out the door. Everybody followed all the way to the shore. In the back of our minds, while we stood there and prayed, we were waiting for the color of the water to change. But it never did, it was as filthy as him. He popped up out of the water and he said it again.
Take me to the river, wash me clean. Let my sins rip down to New Orleans. Out into the middle of the Gulf of Mexico.
Everyone, be sure to give Edna a big shout out. And Edna, if you're still listening, tell Isabel we said hey from right here in the good old U.S. of A. I believe Edna is in the Philippines, I do believe. We're so blessed that I did see her in the chat room a little bit earlier, and that was pretty awesome to me. That's may God bless you, Edna, and your family over there. Remember, we still continue to pray for your visa situation to go through with the blessings and anointing of God upon it, as we pray for Brother Boyd Thomas also in this situation. Excited about one day, hopefully soon, I will get to meet each and every one of you. And I thank God for that. Man, what an awesome God. All right, my right-hand man, I did see a chat go by, I believe, Brother Monroe and Brother Jesse up there listening tonight out of Knott County, Kentucky. Amen. I will get to, I think it was I'll Fly Away. But first, let me jump over here and check the phone lines. Hey, I want to give a big shout-out to Apostle Michael. Amen. Amen. I love you. Can't wait to get to be with you again, man. He says, wow, this program has been wonderful. Just wanted to say good night, and I love each and every one of you and praying for you all. Well, brother, we love you more. We love you more. I tell you, you guys are awesome. Good night, my friend. I pray also tonight that you have a good night's sleep in the arms of Jesus and that you wake up refreshed and on fire for God, ready to go forth. Yes, go forth and continue to proclaim the gospel to a lost and dying world, my friend. In Jesus' name, I pray for each and every one of you tonight to have that peaceful rest. Amen. In the arms of Jesus. All right, man. Hey, let me jump over here. I'm going to hit the phone line. All right. Be blessed in Jesus' name, my friends. Be blessed.
Hello, this is Brother Boyd London in Idaho calling in with my testimony. I love to share my testimony. I'm very grateful for Jesus and for what he's done in my life. James 4:7, resist the devil and he will flee from you, but first you must submit to God. I knew about Jesus for a while and I loved Jesus, but I never really submitted to God. I had things in my life, like anger. I was just controlled by anger. I'd get mad at everything, blow up, curse, cuss. It was not good. I could not get that out of my life. I was controlled by other sins, like impurity and lust and different things, just controlled my life. I couldn't get them out of there. I was selfish. I never helped anybody. even though I knew about Jesus, knew Jesus existed, I did not submit to God and just couldn't get those sins out of my life. But then some brothers got with me, studied the Bible with me, and I started really getting serious about having a relationship with Jesus. I asked him to truly come into my heart and life, and I was serious. I fell in love with Jesus, and I turned my life over to Jesus. I surrendered to him at that point, and I started praying Jesus into my heart, but I started having action to my faith. That's when I started getting involved with churches and studying the Bible with people and helping needy people like the homeless people and orphans and the different kids on drugs and the kids that were having problems. I began helping other people to find Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior, as well as taking care of needy people and helping out different churches and doing different things. And as I did that and submitted to God, all those sins left me. I was set free. I no longer had that anger. I had to blow up all the time and curse. I no longer had the lust and impurity. Don't even think about that stuff. In fact, right now I just think it's disgusting that I had that in my life, because I've been totally changed. Now I love God and I love people and I hate sin. I despise sin. And I just thank Jesus so much that after I truly submitted to him and to his will in my life, turned my life totally over to him, he came into my heart and life and set me free from those sins. Whereas now I can live for him and get other people saved and help people. That's what Jesus has done for me. I was going to hell. I had so much sin in my life. I was going to hell. Well, Jesus came into my heart and life, and he set me free. And he can do the same thing to you, to anyone who's hearing this. If you haven't accepted Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, please do so. Have Jesus come into your heart and life and let him set you free from sin and truly submit yourselves to the will of God, doing his will. God bless you all. Amen.
God is good. Amen. Thank you, Brother Boyd, London Thomas, for calling in and sharing your testimony. You are awesome. All of you, each and every one of you. Here you go, right-hand man.
stay a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joys will never end. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away. I'll fly away.
What did you say?
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I'll meet you there on the crowning day.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready.
No,
walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Someday we'll rise and shine in glory.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Till then I'll tell the gospel story.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready.
No,
walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Trumpet blow.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Till Jesus said it's time to go.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready.
No.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready.
Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John.
Amen and amen. All right, let's remember to pray for Rebecca tonight. Apostle Michael wife there has a test on a computer, I believe it was, as it went by, and let's remember to pray for her that she won't be so nervous and she'll do good, because if God's on your side, who can be against you? Amen. All right, I see. I was trying to remember, we had another request, but I don't remember the name of it. Okay. All right, maybe it'll pop back up in a minute. I'm sorry, the chat room moves so fast sometimes, and I can't back mine up. Amen. But I do apologize if I miss it. Just continue to pray for us. Amen. Praise God. Be blessed, because I wouldn't take nothing from a journey now.
Wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. I gotta make it to heaven somehow. Though the devil tempts me and tries to turn me around. He's offered everything that's got a name. All the wealth I'd won and your worldly fame. If I could still, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.